Hey engineers, between studying for exams, maintaining project deadlines, participating in internships and clubs, and attempting to complete everything else in our calendar, our bodies may naturally activate what's known as the stress response. By recognizing our unique stress profiles, we may learn to elicit the relaxation response to help counteract stress. In this microlesson, we will review how stress affects the body, ways to identify your stress profile, and how to activate your own relaxation response to promote good feeling and performance. What comes to mind when you read the phrase fight or flight? In short, it's the biological response of the sympathetic nervous system to a perceived stressor or threat. Although thousands of years ago, this helped humans survive, today, the long-term, continuous activation of this response can actually impact us negatively if not managed. Here's how. Whenever your body perceives a threat, the sympathetic nervous system is stimulated and key stress hormones, such as cortisol, epinephrine, and norepinephrine, are released. These hormones are intended to promote physical movement and activate many of our organ systems to help us escape from perceived danger. Perhaps an upcoming exam feels like a major stressor. The body may respond by pumping the heart at 2 to 3 times its normal speed, sending blood to the major muscles in the arms and legs to prepare for an emergency and thus making the exam feel physically stressful. Cortisol, a main stress hormone, is secreted at high levels during the body's fight or flight response. Elevated cortisol in the bloodstream for a prolonged period of time, such as with chronic stress, can lead to high blood pressure, impaired cognitive performance, and lowered immunity. Stress signals are normal responses to stress, and everyone has their own unique response to stress. Identifying your own signals is a good first step to managing your body's stress response. Stress can present physically, such as a headache, behaviorally, including foot tapping and finger drumming, emotionally, such as feeling easily upset or discouraged, and cognitively, including trouble thinking clearly. Take a few seconds now to determine your own signals. How do you know when you feel stressed? Okay, so now that we can start to understand our stress signals, how can we work towards reducing an overactive stress response? The secret lies in eliciting the body's relaxation response. According to Dr. Herbert Benson of Harvard Medical School and the founder of Benson Henry Institute for Mind and Body Medicine, the relaxation response is a physical state that counterbalances the body's natural response to stress. His research found that regular use of the relaxation response promoted antioxidation and anti-inflammatory changes that counteracted the effect of stress on the body. By lowering heart rate, blood pressure, and oxygen consumption, blood flow is redirected to the brain, aiding in relaxation. Whenever you start to feel your stress signals, try allocating 5 to 10 minutes to activate your relaxation response. As Dr. Benson said, anything that breaks the train of everyday thought will evoke this physiological state. Engaging in an activity that makes you lose track of time is indicative of the relaxation response. Deep breathing, for example, activates the parasympathetic nervous system, which decreases heart rate, dilates your blood vessels, and lowers blood pressure. The brain associates slow breathing with relaxation, helping us calm down and refocus. Remember, stress is a normal part of daily life. When you feel your stress signals, the body is expressing that you are headed towards distress. During these moments, even for a few minutes, it's important to elicit the relaxation response so that you continue to be and feel like your best self at MIT and beyond. To learn more, check out these resources.